So where does the mom come in that's passed?
My mom.
Okay. So know that she's stepping forward. Your mom made me feel like you were extremely close, but yet she made me feel like you did not get to see her before she died.
Correct.
Your mom makes me feel she was healthy, she took care of herself, she did everything right. She goes, now, Carol, I am gonna tell you this for the last time. Stop feeling that you could have or should have been able to prevent my departure.
It was hard losing her.
She says, you have a lot of loss.
It's been hard. It's a hard life.
I don't know what this is. I felt him the second I walked in this house. His soul is still here.
He died right there. I wouldn't let him die in the hospital. That wasn't where he was supposed to be. He was supposed to be here. They said we couldn't do anything for him anymore. I took him home, and a week later, he died.
He says, I want to thank you for giving me the most beautiful and peaceful passing. Because you were telling him it's okay to go.
I did. I said those exact words.
14 years ago, my husband, John, passed away from a rare cancer called liposarcoma. At the end, the day that he was going to pass, I had a feeling it was going to be that day. I could see how he was struggling to breathe, like he couldn't grasp another breath of air. And I stood at the side of the bed, and I said, it's okay. We will be okay. I am okay with you going. And he opened his eyes as wide could be and stared at me and took the deepest breath, and that was it.
Did somebody die with a lot of blood at their departure? I all of a sudden started tasting blood. So was there a bleed out or like something burst? You died and came back? I can actually feel the soul leaving the physical body when someone dies and comes back. But did somebody else die, though? They showed me survivor's guilt or a feeling, why did someone else die and not me? I don't know what this is. How many children do you have? Your mom says?
Two.
Okay. Because your mom, are there other children, though?
Yeah.
You told me that it was three sons.
Yeah, I was 8 months pregnant with him. There was no heartbeat. My first husband and I, we wanted more kids. So 4 years after Giovanni and before Antonio, we wound up getting pregnant. I wasn't feeling well at work that day, and I left early, and I had severe pains in my stomach. They had me rush over to the hospital, and once they got me in the room and hooked up the monitors, they told me there was no heartbeat. It was called placenta rupture. My placenta ripped away and instantly killed my son. And at the time, I also was losing my life. My organs started to shut down because I was bleeding to death. I went into death-induced coma, and they told my husband I wasn't going to make it. For whatever reason, 12 hours later, I came back to the physical world.
How do you connect with the necklace? You have tons of necklaces on, and they said just talk to her about the necklace because then she'll know that I'm here.
My son that's stillborn's hair is inside of here.
Validating that this is his soul stepping forward as well. So your son says, it's hard for my mom to talk about me. Because you feel that you grieve his loss all alone.
Yeah.
17 years ago, my son Santino passed away of a stillbirth. I never in the wildest dreams thought I was going to lose a child. I don't know how other people will take it, so I tend not to talk about him. It was hard to grieve because I do have two children, and I don't want them to be sad and see me sad all the time. And I feel for a very long time, all I've done is just went through the motions so my kids could have a normal life.
Your husband
shows me on how you move forward, how your life has progressed, correct?
Yeah.
But you still carry this.
Yeah, I guess I fully didn't grieve yet.
How can you heal from the loss of your husband and your mom if you haven't started to heal from the loss of your son?
I don't know.
Your son says it was important that you understood that it was your soul's journey to survive.
I never understood why, though.
Your husband just said to me, he goes, you were sent back for a reason. If you look back and things were different, he said, then our son would have been all alone.
Yeah, I've been an orphan. So they took him and gave me life.
Do not beat yourself up or feel guilty because you survived.
Thank you.
It was his destiny to be and live life on the other side.
In some way, Santino picked me to be his mom so he could be up in heaven with his dad. It needed to be that way because my son Giovanni would have been left without a mother and then eventually without a father. After this reading, I'm not going to continue to blame myself for the loss of my son.
Your husband looked at me and said, Theresa, he said, for the first time in a very long time, I feel like my wife is going to be okay.